Good morning, Rob and Saskia Smit here.
Hello.
Hi. Well, as you all have seen probably yesterday, I made a very, very big mistake. And that was to let Rob fill a balloon and it exploded all over my living room. And I told you in that video he could never pour again. But yesterday he practically begged me that he wanted to pour again. So I thought, okay, it's not completely dry yet, but the ceiling is white again. The only thing is, he wants to work with an air blower. How do you call that?
Compressor.
A compressor. I'm not too thrilled about that because I don't know how hard it will blow.
It's a tool, so it's magic.
Normal people do that with a hair dryer, you can see on Rob's hair,
I don't need a hair dryer.
He doesn't have a hair dryer, so he wanted to use that machine. And I don't know, but I have thought about something. He has to test it with white paint first. So this is...
This is white paint.
Yes, it is. And that's what you're gonna blow first. And there cannot be... Honey?
It can.
No, there cannot be colors in it at the first try.
It can.
No, it cannot.
Maybe. If it works out really good, next time we call the Guinness Book of Records to see how far we can blow the paint.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, and the second scary thing is in my video I asked people where I could buy such a big blowtorch, and they said in a hardware store, and yes, I found it.
Well, I found it.
Yeah, but the scary thing is Rob is going to try that for the first time today, so I hope my house won't get on fire or anything. What we wanted to do, we are Dutch. And we saw the Dutch poor from Rinske Duna. And I will put a link to her channel below. And so that is what we're going to try, the Dutch poor.
2.0.
Yes. And I used my usual recipe. I will put a link in the eye, in the upper corner of this video. There you see it. And Rob has chosen the colors, and they are silver, really dark blue, and a light blue, and a green.
Apple green.
Yes. There's no brand names to that, it's just a craft paint, because it's for Rob. He can practice with that first.
Yeah.
And I hope that won't stick to my walls as much as maybe this machine will explode.
But machinery is cool.
Okay, I will put my camera on the tripod, honey.
Tripod.
Yes. And we are going to try this. And pray for me, guys. I'll be back. And
we're back.
Before I forget it, that machine that we just saw.
The magic compressor.
Mm-hmm. The strength is 3 bar or 40.
PSI.
PSI for the rest from the world, but in the Netherlands we call that 3 bar, so everybody knows. And well, let's just hope it all went always going to be okay.
Yeah, and don't forget, try this at home.
No, we're not sure yet. First, let me see. So, what you're gonna do now, honey?
First, I'm going to pour some white.
Mm-hmm.
It's very thin.
Yeah, it's a much thinner consistency than I would normally use, but I saw that Rinske Duna also had a pretty thin paint, so let's just try that. So you're going to blow now?
Yeah, sure.
Wait.
Why? Oh, that's not necessary.
Yeah, well, there has to be some cardboard around it. What way will you blow the paint?
In the direction of the ceiling, which wall needs to be repainted.
Okay, first blow this way and I will put what? Oh. I'm not going to take any risk. I said blow this way. You yes. Go that way. Okay, this is not too bad. Oh my.
Just a little.
Yeah.
Not even worth mentioning it.
No.
No.
Okay, this was not too bad.
Okay.
And now?
Still wet.
I know, I will hold it.
Just some colors.
Okay. First, the dark blue.
If you call it dark blue, it's dark blue.
Mm-hmm. Then the silver.
A lot of air in it.
I know. That's why we have a torch. You can also pour on top, eh? It doesn't need to be next to each other. Yeah. Okay, so far so good. I will get this out of the way.
Oh.
No, no. First you need to pour some white around it.
No, I want to get rid of some air.
Okay, it's not on fire just yet.
No.
More. Yeah. What way will you blow first?
Same way as I did before.
Okay. Well, there we go. It's a good thing I have my cardboard here.
Oh.
Wait. Let me show you. You see?
Ah, that was before.
Uh-huh.
A little more on this side.
Okay.
Closer.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, thank you. Okay.
It needs to go over the sides, sweetie.
Sure.
Yeah. First you blow it away over the sides, and then you go back.
Something like this?
Yeah, I guess that's what Rinske does. Or else it won't be a Dutch pour. Now you want to go the other side, or are you going to turn the bottles around?
First the torch.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, there are some cells popping up. There's no silicone. It looks very pretty. You chose good colors.
Of course I did.
That's the reason that he is allowed to pour again, because he's very good at it. He is.
Okay. Next step?
I think it's the easiest if you turn the canvas around so you can blow some air to there.
Okay.
Yeah? So if you turn the canvas, then I can stay here. Okay. Oh. Yes? Okay. Very pretty. really love that. Wow, look at that colors. Maybe you should use your torch again because there are little air bubbles there. Look at this bit, guys. This is really pretty. But I will show you a close-up in a minute. If Rob is done.
Beautiful details.
Yeah, very hard. Oh, you're gonna pour some white there?
Yeah. I'm not sure if I like how it is at the moment, so. Oops.
No, that's okay. I like that negative space. Yeah, just leave it like that. It's very pretty, honey. I'm glad you didn't disappoint me by setting my house on fire or blow all that paint to my walls again. I love it. It's very pretty.
This is beautiful.
Yeah. Okay, maybe you can touch up the sides with a little white. Just use your fingers, baby.
Now, what do you think?
Why not? You.
This looks like a tool.
Do you want a brush?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, I will get you one. Oh, there, on your side. Pick one. Whatever. But make sure you don't touch the drippings from the colors.
I know.
Yeah, it's very pretty. Do you already have an idea for the next pour, Arnie?
Oh yeah, I have.
What you gonna do? What tool are you gonna use? Just tell me what tool, that's all.
I think... meep meep. I'm gonna use the same compressor.
Uh-huh.
And something like, how do you call it, a straw?
Yeah.
And I'm going to make something like a flower.
Okay, yeah, can't wait to see that.
A different one.
A different one?
Yep, a different flower.
Okay, well, we'll see. I can't wait. Okay, guys, I will close this up. I will give you a close-up in a minute when Rob is done with his etches.
And I will make some quality photos for the end of the video.
Yes, so at the end of the video there will be some pretty close-up photos. And I am going to show you the details. Okay, we're back. I want you to know, guys, that I'm really, really proud of Rob. I think this is so beautiful.
It's a little more for with the torch.
No, yeah, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay. Really pretty. Nice little details. And although there's no silicone in it, pretty nice cells are popping up. I hope you can see. I will start in the left corner and then go up to show you all that pretty details. I particularly like the dark blue paint. I really love that. Just look at this. It looks like a flower leaf. It's so pretty. And these dark colors, that green and that blue. Wow. And this here, this is really so pretty. Yes, I'm very proud. I'm only a little concerned about his next pour with the straw and the machine, and I don't know what to think about that, but we'll see. Okay, well, say goodbye, honey.
I'm
sorry. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
See you next time. Bye bye. Oh, don't forget to subscribe.